Wow, I got a story for y'all today. And this story is really, really, really off the chain. So, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome to the Mental House with me, your host, Khadija. First of all, let me commend this Florida sheriff. I have to give him a praise and props. Sheriff Smith, who received a tip, and he acted on it. You know, it's hard to believe sometimes when we hear about stories about corruption, and we hear so many of them. Law enforcement, things of that nature. I'm trying to watch my words. And so when we find somebody that's doing something that is just incredibly powerful, I think that they should be given credit, props. They should be commended, and they should be honored for doing the right thing. Because it's really hard to do the right thing when everybody around you is doing the wrong thing. Okay? Because now they all looking at you crazy, like, why you don't want to do the wrong thing with us, right? Well, this particular situation, it's amazing because this guy, he didn't wait for public opinion. He couldn't wait. This is what happened. So I'm just going to commend him because, like I said, I know some cases where this probably wouldn't have happened at all. And it's a different kind of case. So let's check it out.
This Florida sheriff has a slogan.
We don't mess around.
When it comes to meth busts, he's seen it all.
There's not one woman was about to shoot up. She had a needle.
He even live streams the arrests on social media.
Come on, you're going to jail.
Almost a million people watched this one.
Possession of methamphetamine, keeping a drug house. I know we've had complaints out here.
But what Franklin County Sheriff A.J. Smith came across this week shook him to his core. He arrested someone he never thought would be trafficking drugs.
We went to serve a search warrant at a house where a lady had delivered a large quantity of drugs to an informant. And while we're there, I asked her, where did your drugs come from? And she said, your daughter. And I'm like, my daughter? I said, because we're a small town, everybody knows everybody. I said, Kristen? And she's like, yes.
Kristen Kent, his 38-year-old daughter and mother of his beloved grandchildren. I sat down with the sheriff for top story.
We made a controlled buy, and we arrested my daughter. I went to the house and got her.
Wow. What was that like for you?
I can't even put it into words. I mean, when she said Kristen, I was just like, wow. I mean, it's like a gut punch. I mean, you just, you know.
He's a damn good cop.
It's like it's a dream, you know. And, you know, and that's the thing, too.
You got to give him his props.
I know that of all the sheriffs in Florida or probably across the country that speak out about meth,
wow,
I'm probably the loudest voice. And I knew that with this, my daughter any differently.
Sheriff Smith has been one of the state's leading law enforcement voices in the battle against methamphetamine since going into office in 2017.
We can break the generational cycle if we can stop the next generation from becoming addicted.
Putting people in jail does not solve the problem. It's a temporary fix. We've established rehab programs in the jail. We have a person on staff that their main job is finding rehab for people.
In the first half of 2020, deaths caused by meth increased by 56% in Florida, 237 more deaths than the previous year, according to a report from the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. And drug use in Franklin County has skyrocketed even more in recent years compared to the rest of the state.
What I preach to the people that call me every day, they're like, well, what do I do? My son, my daughter, my mother, my sister. Tough love. You know, I had to practice what I've been preaching. I mean, she knows better than anybody in this county.
According to police documents obtained by Top Story, Kristen Kent was charged with trafficking in methamphetamine, possession of cocaine, and possession or use of drug paraphernalia. She's currently out on bond. Sheriff Smith says he did not pay for her bond. We reached out to Kent for comment and did not hear back.
Have you spoken to her since?
Oh, yeah. No, I spoke to spoken to her every day.
What are you communicating to her right now?
Don't do this anymore. I love you, but I don't love what you did. It was wrong, and you should not have done it.
All right, Issa Gutierrez joins us now live on set. A very heavy story. So, Issa, you have a local sheriff who's made it his mission to fight this war on meth. Did he have any sense his daughter was tied up in this?
Tom, that's the crazy thing about
daughter.
This. He says that he was completely shocked when he
his
heard
daughter.
From his perspective, he told me he thought she was doing great. She had a good government agency job, 3 beautiful children, and according to the sheriff, no prior record. He said to me, Tom, you never imagined that your own daughter could be one of the biggest drug traffickers in the county. That's what she's being accused of. But especially, Tom, when again, your father is the sheriff and so outspoken about what drugs can do to a family. So it's just completely devastating.
Thanks for watching.
Did y'all hear that? I mean, that had to be the most difficult decision that that guy had to make. His own daughter. I got mad respect for him. I got mad respect for him because too many in my community know that they kid, they son, or they daughter done shot somebody and they hide them in the basement. They won't tell where they at. They won't. And they kid just killed somebody. And they have no regard for the other person or the law. So I got tall respect for this man. And I don't see color. I see a damn good father. I see the color. And I'm saying, let me take that back. I do see his color. And in me seeing his color, I have respect for him as a human being. With that being said, y'all tell me what y'all think. Could you arrest your own offspring? Let me know in the comments below. See you in the next video.